Chris Moody wrote an article for Yahoo News about how Republicans are taught to talk about Occupy Wall Street. Mr. Republican's content comes from that article.
The Republican Governors Association met this week in Florida to give GOP state executives a chance to rejuvenate, strategize and team build. But during a plenary session on Wednesday, one question kept coming up: how can Republicans do a better job of talking about Occupy Wall Street? I'm so scared of this empty Wall Street effort. I'm frightened to death, said Frank Luntz, a Republican strategist and one of the nation's foremost experts on crafting the perfect political message. They are having an impact on what the American people think of capitalism. Luntz offered tips on how Republicans could discuss the grievances of the occupiers and help the governors better handle all these new questions from constituents about income inequality and paying your fair share. Don't say capitalism. I'm trying to get that word removed and we are replacing it with either economic freedom or free market, Luntz said. The public still prefers capitalism to socialism, but they think capitalism is immoral. And if we were seen as defenders of, quote, Wall Street, end quote, we've got a problem.
Economic freedom? How Orwellian. Freedom is slavery. Why don't you call it theft, or rob the poor? If capitalism lets products succeed on their merits, why do we have to subsidize the corrupt banking industry?
Don't say that the government taxes the rich. Instead, tell them that the government takes from the rich. If you talk about raising taxes on the rich, the public responds favorably, Luntz cautioned. But if you talk about government taking the money from hardworking Americans, the public says no. Taxing, the public will say yes.
Quit distorting the truth. Pay your fair share and quit hiring lawyers to help you weasel out of your obligation. General Electric makes billions of dollars, yet pays no taxes? Warren Buffett said the rich need to pay more in taxes. Quit being greedy.
Republicans should forget about winning the battle over the middle class. Call them hardworking taxpayers. They cannot win if the fight is on hardworking taxpayers. We can say we defend the middle class, and the public will say, I'm not sure about that. But defending hardworking taxpayers and Republicans have the advantage.
No. The middle class is that shrinking group between the rich elite and the poor. Hardworking taxpayer? My relatives have lost their jobs. If you don't work, a Republican will not represent you. My neighbor made so little money last year and had such huge medical expenses that he did not have to pay taxes. So if my neighbor was so poor, he could not be taxed. The Republicans will not represent him?
Don't talk about jobs. Talk about careers. Everyone in this room talks about jobs. Watch this. He then asked everyone to raise their hand if they want a job. Few hands went up. Then he asked who wants a career. Almost every hand was raised. So why are we talking about jobs?
A job is something you get a paycheck from. A career is a future with pay, insurance, benefits, vacation pay and a 401k plan. You are not making jobs, much less careers.
Don't say government spending. Call it waste. It's not about government spending. It's about waste. That's what makes people angry.
Tomatoes, tomatoes. Government spending on the wars you run? Government spending on the naked body scanners that are being banned in Europe because they are unsafe? Government spending on all the vacations and fact-finding missions Congress and the President takes? Angry? You do not have to worry about making people angry. They are angry.
Don't ever say you're willing to compromise. If you talk about compromise, they'll say you're selling out. Your side doesn't want you to compromise. What you use in that to replace it with is cooperation. It means the same thing. But cooperation means you stick to your principles but still get the job done. Compromise says that you are selling out those principles.
When are you up for re-election? The gridlock works for you because the pay just keeps rolling in along with the campaign contributions.
The three most important words you can say to an occupier, I get it. First off, here are three words for you all, I get it. I get that you're angry. I get that you've seen inequality. I get that you want to fix the system. Then, offer Republican solutions to the problem.
I get it, too. Lower minimum wage, cut benefits, steal the money from Social Security, take away more constitutional rights, abolish collective bargaining. Yeah, a lot of great ideas.
Out, entrepreneur. In, job creator. Use the phrases small business owners and job creators instead of entrepreneurs and innovators.
Where's the jobs? Where's the careers? Where's the beef?
Don't ever ask anyone to sacrifice. There isn't an American today in November of 2011 who doesn't think they've already sacrificed. If you tell them you want them to sacrifice, they are going to be pretty angry at you. You talk about how we roll in this together. We either succeed together or we fail together.
What is your sacrifice, Mr. Republican? Government wasting your time listening to me. If we are so all in this together, why do you constantly divide this country and produce gridlock, getting nothing accomplished? Why?
Always blame Washington. Tell them, you shouldn't be occupying Wall Street, you should be occupying Washington. You should occupy the White House because it's the policies over the past few years that have created this problem.
We will get in your face and occupy everywhere. Stop stealing our wages. Stop stealing out Social Security. Stop stealing our pensions. Stop stealing our future with outrageous student loans. Stop doing inside trading. Stop taking envelopes of money and ignoring the people who vote. Stop putting corporations above people. Occupy Wall Street. Occupy Chicago. Occupy Los Angeles. Occupy London. Occupy everywhere.
Don't say bonus. If you give your employees an income boost during the holiday season, never refer to it as a bonus. If you give out a bonus at a time of financial hardship, you're going to make people angry. It's pay for performance.
When are you going to pay for your lack of performance, Mr. Republican? How can I get anything when I don't have a job or a career? Try to occupy the truth, Mr. Republican. Stop spinning the truth. Stop stealing from people. Stop selling your influence to the bankers and to the corporations. When was the last time a corporation bled in a war? Quit putting profits above people. We are the 99%. Represent us too.